How to Double Face Inkle Weave with a Rigid Heddle, brought to you by Rigid Heddle Weaving and joyofweaving.com. Begin by warping your loom with two threads in each slot and hole. Borders can be any colors of your choice. The patterned area should have one background color and one pattern color together in each slot and hole. In my example, I'm using three blue and two white threads for my borders. The patterned area has white background threads and red pattern threads. You can see here part of my border where there's two blue threads in each slot and hole. My patterned area has one white background thread and one red pattern thread in each slot and hole. I start by using a pickup stick, or in this case the Storstalka shuttle. I love this thing. It's awesome. Pick one thread each from the slots and holes of the border threads and your background threads. So when I get done here, all you're going to see is blue and white threads. So one each from each slot and hole. Beat. Now in the shed that you just created, insert your pickup stick. There I go, beat, past the weft. Now, leave the stick in there. Change the shed. This is the second half of this procedure. There's going to be a shed under the cross behind the stick. Insert the shuttle into that. Take your pickup stick out. Beat, and pass the weft. I'm now ready to start over again. I'm going to pick three border threads, all my background threads, and then the border threads again. This is exactly what I did when the heddle was in the up position. It's no different. Beat, insert the stick into that space that I created. To that shed there, past the weft. Leave the stick in there, change the shed, create the shed behind the stick, under the cross. Oh, I forgot to beat. Put that shuttle back in there. Here we go. Take that stick out. Beat. The weft's already passed, so there. All I gotta do is beat it. There we go. I'm ready to start all over again. Just keep repeating this until you have the width of your cloth established, and then you're ready to start doing the pattern. Time to make a pattern. Find a graph that is made on a diamond grid. Each black dot represents a pattern thread that needs to be picked up. All the other ones are your background colors. I start by taking one thread each of my borders, which is three blue and two white. The pattern threads start with three white, two red, one white, one red, one white, three red, one white, and again my borders of two whites and three blues. Now the mechanics are identical to what you've been doing all along. Insert this stick, beat, pass the weft. Change the shed. Turn the stick on edge. Insert the shuttle into the lower shed. Under the cross behind the stick. Remove the stick. Beat and pass the weft. Now you just keep doing this over and over. I'm now ready for the next trick of the design, as you can see here. Start with my borders, one each. Two whites. And now for the pattern, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Two, one, three, and one. And then my two white borders and my three blue borders. And the same thing, insert the stick, beat, pass the weft, change the shed. Turn the stick on edge, insert the shuttle under the cross in that lower shed down there, remove the stick, beat, pass the weft. Rinse and repeat, folks. That's all there is to this. Thank you for watching. I hope this video has helped someone. To show your support, please like, subscribe, visit my websites, and thank you for watching.